And welcome to rainy Birmingham, Alabama, where four teams chase the rainbow to Indianapolis. Game one, perennial powerhouse North Carolina challenges the number one seeds from Stanford. The starting lineups, Capel, Lang, Haywood off a 28-game performance. On Friday night, Cota the veteran, Forte, rookie of the year in the ACC. Mattson, Jacobson, top rookie in the Pac-10. Collins, Mosley, and McDonald for the Stanford Cardinal. Bill Guthridge, who has been to 13 Final Fours as a player, as an assistant to Dean Smith, and as a head coach at Carolina a couple of years ago, against Mike Montgomery, 53 years of age. Montgomery, in his 14th season on the farm in Palo Alto, is the winningest ever Stanford coach. Stanford in white and the Carolina blue for North Carolina. John Cahill, William Bush, and Steve Wellmer with the whistles. Cota brings it in. More than 1,000 assists. Third all-time NCAA history in serving it up. And this is Forte. Partially deflected. And Mosley captures it for Stanford. McDonald brings it in. McDonald with Cota. Lost the handle, but Casey Jacobson there. And demand defense for North Carolina. Dick Hendrick with James Worthy and Spencer Tillman in Birmingham. Inside to Collins. Jaron Collins, one of the twin towers for Stanford, off to Mosley, and it's a 2-0 Stanford lead.
Well, the ability to pass the ball from within the post is an asset for Collins. That time he did an excellent job of finding the open man on the cut. There's Haywood.
Haywood's hook shot not there. Mosley with a rebound for the Cardinal. Bounce pass headed for Mattson, out of bounds to North Carolina.
Well, the interior pass, and you're going to see the cut right here to the basket by Mosley. Good find by Collins. Peripheral vision important against this always moving Stanford ball club.
Stanford has never defeated North Carolina. Eight straight wins for the Tar Heels. Montgomery has tried four times and unsuccessfully to beat Carolina. Favor today against this North Carolina team with 19 wins. That's unusual for them. They've gone 29 straight years with at least 20 wins, and Ed Cota ties it at 2-all.
And I really believe that Ed Cota is going to have to be more aggressive on the offensive end. He's a great assist guy, but the Tar Heels really need him to be more offensive minded against this Stanford stingy defense. They only allow 35% shooting from the field, so it's very important for Carolina to have other people involved on the offensive end.
Into Mattson, over Lang, and it doesn't drop. Rebound to Haywood of North Carolina.
Dick, this team really matches up well against each other. You have Lang in there with Haywood. That really balances out the beef between Mattson and Collins.
And you've got two 6'10 men in Lang and Collins head-to-head. Haywood has his first basket after his career-high 28 against Missouri two nights ago. Carolina leads.
And the word out on Haywood is when he's challenged by bigger, more aggressive power forwards and centers, he has a tendency to have more trouble. But that time he went quickly with the basketball against Mattson.
Freshman Casey Jacobson on his 19th birthday misses his first shot. Want to remind our viewers, those waiting for Florida, Illinois, Temple, Seton Hall games will be leaving this game, joining special interest games in your local area. We'll be kept up to date on the progress of this game with scoring reports and highlights. Haywood giving Carolina a second and third chance. Blocked underneath by Mattson. 4-2.
And you can see the frustrations on Haywood's face. He doesn't like the physical play.
Mosley blocked, but Collins saves, and now Jacobson slowing it up.
Well, so far, teams have been very physical on the defensive end, taking away the tendencies, denying the basketball, making it very difficult to run their offenses. There's a good pick for Mosley at the top.
15-footer by Mosley is short. And the rebound to Forte. Here comes Cota.
And it is a quick-paced game thus far. Both teams eliminating offensive boards, rebounding critical.
Capel outside, 6'8". Brother played at Duke. Dad coaches at Old Dominion. This is Chris Lang. And Carolina leads 6-2.
Carolina's a basketball team that had a very inconsistent regular season. They've had injuries. Ronald Curry missing from the ball club. Now is a time that they're starting to pick it up, and the momentum is flowing in North Carolina's favor.
And the reach-in foul on Capel. The first foul of the game. And with that, a timeout. Just over 4 minutes have been played. North Carolina off to a solid start. And welcome to rainy Birmingham, Alabama, where four teams chase the rainbow to Indianapolis. Game one, perennial powerhouse North Carolina challenges the number one seeds from Stanford. The starting lineups, Capel, Lang, Haywood off a 28-game performance. On Friday night, Cota the veteran, Forte, rookie of the year in the ACC. Matson, Jacobson, top rookie in the Pac-10. Collins, Mosley, and McDonald for the Stanford Cardinal. Bill Guthridge, who has been to 13 Final Fours as a player, as an assistant to Dean Smith, and as a head coach at Carolina a couple of years ago, against Mike Montgomery, 53 years of age. Montgomery, in his 14th season on the farm in Palo Alto, is the winningest ever Stanford coach. Stanford in white and the Carolina blue for North Carolina. John Cahill, William Bush, and Steve Wellmer with the whistles. Cota brings it in. More than 1,000 assists. Third all-time NCAA history in serving it up. And this is Forte. Harshly deflected. And Mosley captures it for Stanford. McDonald brings it in. McDonald with Cota. Lost the handle, but Casey Jacobson there. And demand defense for North Carolina. Dick Hendrick with James Worthy and Spencer Tillman in Birmingham. Inside to Collins. Jaron Collins, one of the twin towers for Stanford, off to Mosley, and it's a 2-0 Stanford lead.
Well, the ability to pass the ball from within the post is an asset for Collins. That time he did an excellent job of finding the open man on the cut. There's Haywood.
Haywood's hook shot not there. Mosley with a rebound for the Cardinal. Bounce pass headed for Matson, out of bounds to North Carolina.
Well, the interior pass, and you're going to see the cut right here to the basket by Mosley. Good find by Collins. Peripheral vision important against this always moving Stanford ball club.
Stanford has never defeated North Carolina. 8 straight wins for the Tar Heels. Montgomery has tried 4 times and unsuccessfully to beat Carolina. Favored today against this North Carolina team with 19 wins. That's unusual for them. They've gone 29 straight years with at least 20 wins, and Ed Cota ties it at 2-all.
And I really believe that Ed Cota is going to have to be more aggressive on the offensive end. He's a great assist guy, but the Tar Heels really need him to be more offensive minded against this Stanford stingy defense. They only allow 35% shooting from the field, so it's very important for Carolina to have other people involved on the offensive end.
Into Matson, over Lang, and it doesn't drop. Rebound to Haywood of North Carolina.
Dick, this team really matches up well against each other. You have Lang in there with Haywood. That really balances out the beef between Matson and Collins.
And you've got 2 6'10" men in Lang and Collins head-to-head. Haywood has his first basket after his career-high 28 against Missouri 2 nights ago. Carolina leads.
And the word out on Haywood is when he's challenged by bigger, more aggressive power forwards and centers, he has a tendency to have more trouble. But that time he went quickly with the basketball against Manson.
Freshman Casey Jacobson on his 19th birthday misses his first shot. Want to remind our viewers, those waiting for Florida, Illinois, Temple, Seton Hall games will be leaving this game, joining special interest games in your local area. We'll be kept up to date on the progress of this game with scoring reports and highlights. Haywood giving Carolina a second and third chance. Blocked underneath by Manson. 4-2.
And you can see the frustrations on Haywood's face. He doesn't like the physical play.
Mosley blocked, but Collins saves, and now Jacobson slowing it up.
Well, so far, teams have been very physical on the defensive end, taking away the tendencies, denying the basketball, making it very difficult to run their offenses. There's a good pick for Mosley at the top.
15-footer by Mosley is short. And the rebound to Forte. Here comes Cota.
And it is a quick-paced game thus far. That both teams eliminating offensive boards, rebounding critical.
Cable outside, 6'8". Brother played at Duke. Dad coaches at Old Dominion. This is Chris Lang. And Carolina leads 6-2.
Carolina's a basketball team that had a very inconsistent regular season. They've had injuries. Ronald Curry missing from the ball club. Now is a time that they're starting to pick it up, and the momentum is flowing in North Carolina's favor.
And the reach-in foul on Capel, the first foul of the game. And with that, a timeout. Just over 4 minutes have been played. North Carolina off to a solid start. For the four teams who play today as they look ahead to the Sweet 16 opportunity, and two great teams in this first game. North Carolina off to a good start, 6-2. The battle inside should be mighty interesting.
Yeah, it's going to be really physical inside, particularly between Brendan Haywood and Mark Madman Mattson. Mattson, a very aggressive player, pushing Haywood off the post. Fouls could be a problem, but it's going to be a lot of beef frying down in the paint this afternoon.
You see Brendan Haywood given a breather early by Bill Guthridge. The Carolina team used only seven players in their win on Friday night, and Coda played the full 40.
And Carolina immediately goes to their zone, something that is their strength, but they can't afford to give up an offensive rebound to Mattson.
And Mattson, without Haywood in there to intimidate, has his first basket at 6-4.
And Haywood, you know, already fatigued a little bit just from the few minutes of physical play against Collins and Mattson.
Forte misses. Mattson rebounds. Here comes McDonald for Stanford.
The bigger player in Jason Capel on Jacobson, hoping to take away some of his vision and outside shooting. Good pump fake by Mattson.
But Capel came in from the blind side to swat it away. But Mattson, oh, he loves the physical nature of the game.
And you just can't box him out. He's so good at spinning and moving. He's just an animal inside. But Jason Capel may be the X factor here this afternoon. He's a guy that has to score. He had 14 points and 11 rebounds against Missouri, so he has been active of late.
Mosley for three, and Stanford reclaims the lead at 7-6. 5 minutes into the game.
Mosley on the freshman Forte, getting loose. Really does a good job of setting the pick and then popping open for the open shot.
Coda off the drive. Rebound Mattson. Oh, he goes up and you can just read, "I want it," on his back.
Well, you look at his body, he looks like a defensive end. I mean, he is thick.
And he's playing against a defensive end, Julius Peppers, as McDonald throws it away. Peppers in for Haywood. He's 6'7", was a freshman, brilliant star in the Carolina football team at 6'7" and 270.
And Brendan Haywood comes back in the game, and Chris Wang out of the game. Carolina's big man will experience some fatigue against the Beef Brothers of Collins and also Mattson, who also goes out of the game.
Jason Collins, the twin brother of Jaron Collins, comes in for Stanford. So both Collins twins on the floor. Mattson giving a breather. And Haywood in for Peppers. No, Peppers stays. And the turnover. Mosley from Las Cruces, New Mexico. This is Jaron Collins and his twin brother Jason. Way to pick him out. He has the two knee pads and the longer hair, and a whistle against North Carolina.
Julius Pepper, with his 270 pounds, is a player that can provide some strength, but he has a height disadvantage against Collins.
Stanford leading 7-6. We've played 6 minutes here in Birmingham.
Carolina goes to the zone, and that's where Stanford's eyes light up. They're such a good outside shooting team.
Good ball movement. Mosley for another three. Back-to-back trays for David Mosley.
Well, Mosley's finding the range. He's the senior. He used to be somewhat of a talker on the court, but he's really calmed down and started to play his game.
Haywood comes out to set the high pick, and then holding call against Jason Collins as he tried to hold Haywood back. I want to remind our viewers waiting for the Temple Seton Hall game. We'll be leaving this game in a few minutes to join that game of special interest in your area. We'll be kept up to date on scoring highlights throughout the course of the afternoon. Connecticut and Tennessee awaiting the second game here in Birmingham. The winners advance. Will play each other in Austin on Friday night.
And Jerry Green's point guard, Tony Harris, had a slow start in their last game, but he's a player that's instrumental to their transition game and their offense.
Pass into Forte, and he's left unguarded. First points for Joseph Forte. It's 10-8 Stanford.
Well, Mosley's been in his ear a little bit early in the game, but I don't think that's going to shake Forte. If anything, it's going to give him a little bit of more incentive.
Jaron Collins with Haywood on him. McDonald draws Cota. Collins, they're daring him to shoot the 15-footer. He takes it. First points for Jaron Collins, a 6'10 junior from North Hollywood, California. His brother is 6'11.
And if he can knock that shot down, that really puts the pressure on Carolina's defense, because Brendan Haywood must come out to defend that little 15-footer.
Cota with that high dribble. Only the third man in NCAA history to accumulate 1,000 assists. And taking the pressure, McDonald into Haywood with 9 on the clock. Haywood dishes it off to Peppers, and he's fouled.
Haywood really, really active this afternoon. He knows he cannot be stationary against this defense. Take a look at Collins at the top of the key now. Haywood does not want to come out that far, and if he can knock that little 15-footer down, he's going to be very successful. But look at the activity and the quickness. A little spin move, pass over to Peppers. Excellent interior passing so far for both teams, particularly Haywood recognizing the double team and the pressure.
Peppers has his first free throw. Jaron Collins, you saw him reaching in, picks up his first foul. This is number 25, Tony Giovacchini. He comes in to replace Michael McDonald, then will play the point for Stanford.
Mike Montgomery loves to run players in and out, trying to wear you down. Jacobson didn't get it off against Caples, so Mendez comes in, and he's going to try to see if he can shake Caples a little bit.
He's instant offense, as we saw in the win against South Carolina State on Friday night. Get a couple of quick threes. Collins inside is Mosley against the taller trees, and traveling is the call.
Well, Mosley is very active. He's been a floor leader thus far on the open shot and on that particular time on the offensive glass.
Chris Lang returns to the North Carolina lineup, replacing Peppers. Lang at 6'10".
Well, Chris Lang had the, you know, the viral infection, that he had the shin splints, but he is a player. I really believe he's going to have to demonstrate mind over matter, particularly against this Stanford team in play, and be effective in the post.
Jason Collins down inside. He's defending against Haywood. He's the more muscular, physical of the twin brothers. Cota short on his drive, and here comes Mendez. Mosley to Collins. And a push on Haywood. First foul on Brendan Haywood.
And that's another problem that Stanford presents. They have enough players to put Brendan Haywood in jeopardy of getting in foul trouble.
12-9, Stanford leading Carolina. Worthy and Spencer Tillman in Birmingham. Spence, what do you have for us?
Well, Dick, I talked to both coaches before first tip. Bill Guthrie told me he is concerned about Stanford's balance. The M&M guys outside from the perimeter, very dangerous. Inside, he's also concerned about their presence. Now, as far as Montgomery is concerned, he says keep Cota in front of them. That's the key to their success today.
All right, Spencer. Mike Montgomery, who continues to rack up solid season after solid season on the farm in Palo Alto, and has done a tremendous job recruiting, especially drawing the top players out of Southern California, where UCLA used to have its pick.
Very difficult to do, to get players out of California.
Jacobson, Giovacchini. Jacobson way out. That's a pro-range jumper. Mattson gets a hand on it, and it's out of bounds to Stanford. Well, there's an example of some of the players, the two Collins twins, Jacobson from Glendora, Mark Mattson from Danville. Those are all players that normally would stay in that Southern California environment, but he's gone in there and taken his pick. First points for Jason Collins, and Stanford has a 14-9 lead.
And so far, Mark Mattson has been unable to block him out. He's been able to get some offensive boards.
Haywood inside for North Carolina. And that's what they need for him to be aggressive offensively.
Well, he does such a good job of sealing his man, and that's a tough angle pass over the top, but with his height, and he never brings it down, he keeps it up. That's to his advantage.
And Collins left alone at the free throw line. Madsen sneaks in for the rebound. No whistle, and back out it comes. Madsen and Haywood know each other well. They were team members in the World University Games in Spain this past summer. So they worked out against each other, like each other.
Right now that responsibility is leaning on Chris Lang as a player that is unable to.
Oh my. Capel had a shot at grabbing that ball and giving it to his teammate. Didn't need the hurry. It goes out of bounds to Stanford.
There's the battle. There's Collins. Look at the seal. And over the top, never brings it down, straight up before Madsen can get there.
In the paint, each team with 6 points. But look at Stanford, 13 rebounds already. A lot of those second chances offensively. Jacobson takes it inside, can't connect. Cota goes the other way for North Carolina, trailing 14 to 11. Knocked away, and Madsen picks up the loose ball. It appeared to be Joe Bikini who got a hand on it.
Lakota's good at penetrating, but you can't dribble right into the teeth of the defense, particularly against this Stanford defense. They're very stingy inside.
Jacobson again from long distance. Long toss down to Forte, and a cross body block by Joe Bikini. Forte trying to get down court, and Joe Bikini knocked him down, and no whistle.
Well, the ball was in the air, and the referee probably said no one had a chance to get to it, but to me, that's that speaks for itself.
And the Carolina fans, understandably, on their feet, protesting the call or no call. That's Ryan Mendez, who showed the other night he can hit the three and nails that tray.
Well, Mendez, that's how they can hurt you. He's automatic microwave off the bench, Mr. Offense. Team looks to him to break things open when they need to.
Foul underneath, and it's going to go against number 34, Jason Collins of Stanford. That's his second, trying to ward off the 7-footer Brendan Haywood.
But as long as Haywood is moving around and being active, he's going to get some fouls. But if, when he's stationary, is when Stanford will have some success.
Jaron Collins, twin brother, replaces Jason.
They're trying to hit him high. They're trying to hit him at the free throw line and stop him there, but such a big body. Lang.
Left alone inside. Got away from Madsen, and it's 17-13. Lang with his 4th point.
And it's very important for Chris Lang to put some pressure on Mark Madsen. So far, Madsen has been able to run free offensively and on the offensive board.
Mendez has another 2. 5 points for Ryan Mendez off the bench. He's averaging 9.5 a game.
How good is this team when they have Jacobson and Mendez who can light it up?
Capel barely touching the ball here in the first half. Haywood makes his spin move, and another whistle against Stanford. This one is going to be on Madsen, his first.
And this is the attitude that they want Haywood to have all the time. He hadn't showed it all year, but look at the deep position. Good strong pivot moves off of Madsen, shooting 2. Oh, actually, he's not shooting 2. It was before the shot.
4th team foul on Stanford. 5-3 on Carolina. Max Owens from Macon, Georgia, Jr. has replaced Forte for Carolina. Cota shots out the play. This is Owens, averaging 8.5 a game. Find an opening, get it inside to Haywood. That seems to be the scheme for Carolina. Owens pops. Didn't take him long to fire one up. And Mendez the rebound.
Max Owens is another one of those players that has to step up. He and Capels are the only 2 X factors that really can give a boost to this Carolina offense.
Stanford leading by 6 with 8 minutes to go here in Birmingham. Jaron Collins, not there, and up for the rebound is Owens, or Capel, and he is fouled.
Well, Dick, you and I earlier were talking about Capels. He's the X factor, 11 boards against Missouri.
19-13, Stanford. Welcome back, 7:49 remaining in the first half. Stanford leads by 6. Let's take a look at our Mountain Dew game summary. Out rebounding North Carolina 2-1. That was the key statistic on that summer.
Yeah, Stanford does such a good job collectively, and it's really going to fall in the responsibility of Chris Lang. Is going to have to help out a little bit. Cable's doing his part, but can't afford to get out rebounding, particularly on the offensive end.
Ed Cota and Lang outside with Haywood. Inside to Lang, batted away and out of bounds to North Carolina.
So far, the Stanford has done an excellent job of keeping Ed Cota out of the paint, and that really, you know, trickles down to some of the perimeter shooters like Forte, who's been absent in this game.
This is Owens. Lang from 17. Good job by Haywood to get a hand on it, but it was deflected out to Collins, and McDonald back in the game for Stanford, the point guard.
Good Manson working for position.
Lang guarding him. And a hold against Chris Lang of North Carolina, his first. And on the team foul, North Carolina's fourth, Stanford has committed five.
When you're active like Manson, spinning and always moving, you can almost force a foul on your opponent. Good activity.
Starting five for Stanford on the court. Only Owens off the bench and four starters for North Carolina. It wouldn't fall for Collins, but underneath the shorter Mosley, and Mosley gets another offensive rebound. He's only 6'4", but not afraid to go inside. That's seven offensive rebounds to one, the advantage for the Cardinal.
And Mosley's been in there very active. I think he must have two or three offensive boards himself.
Max Owens committed his first foul for North Carolina, and here's David Mosley, the 6'4 senior from Las Cruces, New Mexico. Vario toughened, never met his father. Mother Nelly, the great influence in his life, is Owens out, and freshman sensation Joseph Forte back in for Carolina. Mosley gives Stanford its biggest lead at 21-13. He leads all scorers with 10. Under seven to go in the first half.
And it's about time for Carolina to try to find Forte and get him involved. He can also create off the dribble because Ekotas hadn't been able to do it this far.
Good call. Forte tips the shot, and a good save by Capel. And Carolina gets a second chance. Inside to Haywood, over Mattson. Well done by the big man, Brendan Haywood. He has six.
Just active. He's playing with a lot of energy, a lot of intensity. Mattson, Haywood, we'll be watching that matchup through the afternoon.
Good job of Capel on Jacobson. Inside Mattson, around Lang, and the block by Haywood, but a foul.
Well, Haywood doing a pretty good job of trying to push him out. But the shot from 7 foot Haywood is tough. But look at the pump fake. Step through underneath. The block was there, but Chris Lang got him on the lower part of the body.
Lang's second foul, and that sends Mark Mattson to the line. He's been Mad Dog since school teacher in the fifth grade. Stuck him with that moniker. It's maybe appropriate on the court, but off the court you won't find a more exciting, terrific kid. He said that if he had his dream dinner with three people any time in history, it would be Abraham Lincoln, John Wooden, and Cervantes. There are the parents who said one thing we always had. We made sure plenty of books in the home. Spencer Tillman talked with them on Friday night. Basketball is okay, but doing a lot of reading. Can you think about sitting down, Mark Mattson with the Wizard of Westwood, Abraham, Honest Abe, and the Man of La Mancha. That,
that just
tells you where he is.
That just shows you the depth of Mattson, not as an athlete, but as a human being. He's just a delightful person to be around. He's always coming out before the game starts and chatting, and just a delightful young man.
6 minutes to go in this first half. A 7-point lead for Stanford, and a turnover. The save by Collins. McDonald breaks out but doesn't have the numbers. Mosley will take the three anyway. Rimmed out. And Jacobson with another offensive rebound. Stanford. That's a key to this first half, no question.
And Carolina did such a good job against Missouri. They out rebound Missouri with a big margin, so collectively they're going to have to do it against Stanford because Stanford guards do a good job of rebounding as well.
McDonald fails on the three-point attempt. Haywood with the rebound.
Carolina's got to find some other offense. They cannot milk Brendan Haywood to death. They got to find Kota Forte, not active. Set some picks. There's Capel. He's a guy that's also capable of scoring.
Unable to hit on the drive, and Jaron Collins with the rebound. McDonald surveying the court as he brings it in. Collins from 17. Short. Oh, look, the hands of Mosley. It appeared that ball was getting away, and he still gets it. Terrific facility. Well, Mosley.
He's got great hands, and the ability to tip the ball to yourself and get off the floor quickly is a key to Mosley's rebounding ability. He's not a tall guy, but he has a knack for where that ball is.
Less than 5 minutes left in this first half. Carolina with the ball, down by 7 to Stanford. Number 8 seed North Carolina, the top seed here in the South, Stanford University. Forte can't get inside that tough defense. Pepper's back in the game. The left-hander not there. Haywood tips. Haywood trying to get the rim. Peppers, and he scores. Julius Peppers pounding the boards as his third point of the game.
Well, one thing about Peppers, he's not going to be moved out of the way. And as much beef as the Stanford team has, it's good to have him in there to kind of act as a fire hydrant. He's not going anywhere, and he's strong with both hands.
Madsen up on top. Collins underneath. And Madsen just deflected by Peppers. Out of bounds to Stanford. Under 4 to go. Timeout in Birmingham. Meet game summary. James Worthy.
I really believe that the deal right now with Stanford is their ability to get the offensive boards. They have 9, and that's turning into second opportunities. Carolina must take away the second shot. Stanford's too good of a basketball team to give up second shots to.
22-17, the Cardinal leads. North Carolina with 3:57 left in this first half, and Stanford's ball, Casey Jacobson, looking for his first points. Jacobson, who is the leading Stanford scorer with 14 and a half a game. And Capel for North Carolina yet to score. Jacobson has it stripped away.
And because he hadn't scored, he's really trying to force the issue. I mean, Carolina's done a good job of taking one of the key ingredients from Stanford. Although Mendez has come in and scored, Jacobson must allow the game to come to him.
Inside it goes to Lang.
The jump hook.
And well off the mark. Good defense by Collins. Here comes McDonald for Stanford. Jacobson for 3. There's his first points and a birthday candle on the tray. 25-17.
And he was standing out here on the G that says Birmingham on the floor. That was way beyond the arc.
The reach around by Collins, and that'll be a foul on Jaron Collins, his second.
Such a great player, put it on the floor, but you can't give him this kind of airspace because he is a pure shooter from anywhere on the basketball court. That was way downtown.
Haywood, a brief rest, returns. Lang out for North Carolina. And he learned that shot in his own backyard. Dad clearing citrus trees away. They build a half court, regulation, breakaway rims, lights, and all the works. 3 brothers all playing college ball in the Jacobson clan. And there's Capel's first points of the game, and he answers Jacobson's 3 with one of his own.
The X factor. We talked about it a little bit during the break. Capel's going to have to step up. He had 14 points and 11 rebounds, getting back to his natural position, which is a shooting small forward.
Haywood out on Collins, and Collins with a jumper. Mendez tips it in. Boy, he just gives them such offensive clout off the bench.
Mosley, Mendez, you would think would be the Collins twins and Manson, but so far on the boards for Stanford has been the guard play, something Carolina has to correct.
The defense by Madsen as he fronts Haywood. Mendez moves to the left corner. He has 7, and Mosley with 10. Inside, Madsen with a fake, blocked by Peppers. That's twice he's blocked Madsen. Forte. Carolina. Jacobson and Forte, the two first-year players matched defensively. Forte scores. Joseph Forte, the freshman from Greenbelt, Maryland, 6'4" over Jacobson. Jacobson is 6'6".
I really believe that they're going to have to let Forte handle the basketball a little bit from the top. He can get inside the defense and cause it to collapse as well. Not as good a passer as Cota, but definitely can break down the defense.
Inside, and the pass by Mendez off the fingertips of Manson. And a turnover, the sixth by Stanford. 1:14 to go in the half.
And even though Chris Lang is taller and bigger than Peppers, Peppers is stronger, and he has the capability of pushing Matson out just a little bit farther than he'd like to catch the basketball.
Cota looks over at head coach Bill Guthrie, who shouts out the play. Matson battling inside with Haywood, getting help from Collins defensively. Capel from long range hits another three, and it's 27-25 Stanford.
And there's your guy. Now, if Carolina is going to stay close and be successful, I honestly believe that Capels is the guy that's going to have to step up. He's been very active in slowing Jacobson down.
Jacobson partially blocked by Peppers. That's his third. And a chance to tie or take the lead, North Carolina.
21 seconds left. They want to get a good shot going into the locker room. They've done a good job of keeping this game close. Only 2 points down. Jacobson, not really a factor. However, Mosley and Mendez have been.
3 second difference in the clocks. 10 now on the shot clock. Cota with five. Peppers with four. Here late in the first half to tie the game, and that's the third foul on Jaron Collins.
And that's a big foul. You want to watch the pick and the roll. Peppers with the left hand. No one is going to come between him and that big broad shoulder chest of his. Good utilization of the left hand going to the basket.
The three-point play for Julius Peppers, and North Carolina leads 28-27. Stanford calls time. They got 6 seconds and change to try to reclaim it. $1 million to the scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. There's the man who has given Bill Guthridge big minutes, and he's a big man. Julius Peppers, averaging 4 a game, has led this comeback. 8-0 run. David Mosley with 10 is the top scorer for Stanford, and the Cardinal with 6.3 seconds to get off a shot. McDonald will hurry it into the offensive end. And it's stolen by, yes sir, Peppers, and he'll get a shot away. North Carolina with 8 unanswered points in the final 2.5 minutes of this first half overcomes an 8-point Stanford lead, and the North Carolina Tar Heels lead at the intermission 28-27. CBS exclusive coverage of the NCAA basketball championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station. Welcome back to Birmingham. Ready for the second half. North Carolina leads Stanford 28-27. Let's go to Spencer Tillman.
All right, Coach Montgomery, now that smothery defense that has typified your team's play all year long, not there. They shot nearly 46% in the first half. What did you tell your kids?
Well, they do have 28 points, so I don't know that they're scoring at will. The two threes right before the half hurt us. We had a 7-point lead and they hit two threes deep. We turned the ball over a couple times too. We should have a bigger lead. We got to play smarter. We're doing a pretty good job inside, but we're not doing a good enough job closing back to the ball. We're ahead. We just got to play a little bit better.
Good luck to you in the second half.
That's interesting. Montgomery scoreboard, they're ahead, and he feels his team is ahead. You said the X factor would be Jason Capel, and those two threes indeed sparked that 8-0 run.
Absolutely. He started out on Casey Jacobson, slowed him down. Jacobson only 1 of 6 shooting. Then he was able to get his offense off with the two big threes, but then Stanford sending in Mendez, 7 points, and The Stanford team has 10 offensive rebounds. That's something the Tar Heels must eliminate this half.
And how about the effort, as you look at Ryan Mendez on the bench, the effort of Julius Peppers, the defensive end. He was a freshman All-America, started all the games for the Tar Heels in football, a tremendous talent. Didn't even start practicing in this sport until after Thanksgiving, and he chips in with 6 points and three key blocks inside to help spark the Tar Heels. Here we go, second half, as these two teams battle for the Sweet 16 and a date in Austin on Friday night.
Carolina starting with the man-to-man capo on Jacobson. Again, I'm sure Mike Montgomery's going to try to figure out a way to free Jacobson up just a little bit.
Collins stymied inside. Jacobson with Capel. Capel's 2 inches taller. Madsen, Mosley, blocked by Haywood. Forte hustles it to the other end.
Good pick by Lang.
The three won't fall. Collins with a rebound. Collins, McDonald, Madsen, Mosley, and Jacobson for Stanford. Lang, Cota, Forte, Haywood, and Capel for North Carolina. And another miss by Madsen, and here comes Cota.
Well, he's not going to be able to back Haywood down. He did the right thing by facing him, but he couldn't knock down the little nine-footer.
Chris Lang, that jump hook is there. North Carolina leads by three. They led by four early in the game at 6-2. Biggest lead for Stanford was 8 at 25-17.
And Chris Lang, his freshman year, that shot was unstoppable. Unfortunately, the injury slowed him down somewhat, but if he could ever get back to that jump hook inside, he could be another weapon inside for Coach Guthridge.
Mosley, who has had the hot hand, misses on the long range shot, and Lang sets up Cota, and Carolina with a 30-27 lead. Patient offense for the Tar Heels. Cota running the show. Played every minute since he came here to Birmingham, all 40 on Friday night. North Carolina trying to stun number one seed Stanford, and the Tar Heels have moved up by 5, 32-27. They trail by 8 late in the first half, an 8-0 run before the buzzer took them to the locker room in front by 1, and they've scored the first two baskets of this second half.
And the Carolina defense has dictated their offense. The first half, there's a big steal by Cota. Carolina has a couple of numbers, Forte.
And the block, but a foul on McDonald of Stanford.
As I was saying, the first half, it was Capel's good defense on Jacobson. Then he hit the big threes. Now in the second half, Chris Lane has established himself inside, putting a little bit more pressure on that interior defense. But Cota, excellent pass to Forte. He's shooting two.
And Cota with a big steal at the other end. You could see his senior leadership, the 6'2 veteran from Brooklyn, New York, Tilden High School and St. Thomas More School. He was one of five Carolina freshmen to be the ACC Freshman of the Year. And Chris Lang goes slowly off the court and holding his left rib cage.
Well, he got hit right in the sternum area, and maybe the wind left him a little bit. He's gasping.
Julius Peppers, one of the stars off the bench for Carolina, replaces him. And at the line, freshman Joseph Xavier Forte from Greenbelt, Maryland. Freshman of the Year in the ACC this year. His mother moved him and the family from Georgia up to Maryland so they could play for the legendary Morgan Wooten, Sam Perkins, Michael Jordan, J.R. Reed, Cota, and Forte, ACC Freshman of the Year. That's quite an elite list. Who made it your year in the ACC?
Well, unfortunately, James, we had a 7'4" guy from Virginia named Ralph.
Ralph Sampson.
Ralph's house.
Biggest lead of the game for Carolina, 34-27, as Forte hit a deuce. Arm wrestling inside, and Peppers called for the foul. Mark Madsen trying to get inside, and Chris Lang is being helped to the locker room, having trouble breathing.
And you really hate to see him go out of the ball game. He had hit two big buckets back-to-back and was starting to establish himself inside against Collins and Madsen.
Peppers' second foul. 2.5 minutes into the second half, and North Carolina asserting itself. They were the number 8 seed a couple of years ago, remember? Knocked out Oklahoma in the second round. Oklahoma was seeded 1. And another foul, this time Haywood with a reach. That's the kind of foul that Bill Guthridge just painfully watches. Barely touch him. Why reach?
Well, hey, with the size, you're absolutely right, Dick. There's no use to reach or push. You have the height advantage. Make the player shoot over you. Unfortunately, that's not a good foul.
Jacobson inside to score, and that ends a 14-point streak by North Carolina. Eight at the end of the first half and a 6-0 start here in the second half.
And he knew Haywood just got a foul. Haywood kind of laid off of the block that time, but Mike Montgomery setting up some plays for Jacobson to get open.
McDonald on Cota. Forte partially blocked. And Collins grabs the rebound. McDonald for Stanford with 16:44 left in the second half. And Stanford trailing North Carolina by five. Inside. And it's Jason Collins bumped. One official has started to call traveling, but on the bump, the other rules foul. And the foul will go against whom? Jason Capel, his second.
And I really think it was the push that caused the travel, although it looked like a little pivot foot right there was moving, but Capel did come in behind him with a little shove.
13 foul Carolina, one on Stanford here in the second half. Collins, Haywood, the big tree inside. Jacobson, long range, not there. Mosley slips inside and scores again. Again, David Mosley at 6'4", getting an offensive rebound and put back.
And as good as Forte is as a player, he's really still a freshman. Mosley recognizes that Forte, not expecting Mosley to rebound, but if he learned anything from the first half, you got to put a body on Mosley. He's going to the post.
Haywood inside, back outside. Good ball movement by Carolina. Forte to Haywood. Good spin move and a block by Madsen. And Madsen raising his arms to the Stanford faithful. Get into the game. 34-31 as the Cardinal trailing by seven have scored back-to-back baskets and get the big defensive play from Madsen.
Madsen realizes he needs that six man. The fans, he knows they're not at home. The neutral site, Mosley off the down pick. Starting to warm up again. He got the offensive boards. Comes right back with a deuce.
Down the bottom of the well on the Mosley jumper. He leads all scoring with 14. And Stanford quickly rallies from seven down with six unanswered points. It's a one-point game. Watch out, Mosley, as he crashes into the press row trying to capture that ball.
Well, Brendan Haywood doing a good job. Spin move. But look at the madman coming over. Get it out of here. And then Mosley on the down pick as a result of the good defense. Too late. Lights out.
One seed in the West, second number one seed to lose in the second round. And how about Gonzaga, the number 10 seed? They are the Cinderellas again, advancing to the Sweet 16, first time ever, number 10 back-to-back years. Chris Lang's back on the bench. Spencer, what's the story?
Mark Davis was admonishing Lang as he came back onto the court that you're going to be fine. Fine. Lang was obviously concerned about the fact that it was more than just indeed a cramp of some sort, but the trainer again reassured him that you will be fine. Everything is okay. He's back in the game.
Lang feeling chest pains and was worried about that. And Cota will create a heartbreak to Stanford if he's able to penetrate that deeply.
Well, he's not been effective penetrating from the point guard, so they let Forte handle and bring Cota off of them on those down picks.
Mosley with a hot hand for Stanford, carrying the Cardinal. 17 points for the senior.
You really think you might want to put a little bit more experience on Mosley, because Forte, a good offensive player, can't match.
Stolen by Mosley, reaching in, knocked it away. Madsen ripping the ball away from three Tar Heels. A tie game at 36. Jacobson. And he is blocked by Haywood. Cota for Carolina to Forte. Thought about the three, and Cota feeds Haywood. Jumper is good, and the foul. 8 points now for big Brendan Haywood, and Carolina back in front by two.
Or anytime you let him get that kind of position down low, all he has to do is turn and jump hook. Good position and a good feed by Cota. And on the other end of the floor, Jacobson still hadn't found the flow, forcing the issue too much once again.
Fouls on Jason Collins, so both Collins twins with three fouls, and Madsen out hustling Jason Capel for that loose ball.
Oh, and there's Mosley left alone, but he hit the underside of the rim. Blocked by the rim.
He felt the footsteps coming.
38-36, Carolina. 6 minutes gone here in the second half, and Cota is fouled as he goes up with the jumper. Michael McDonald with the foul for Stanford, his second. And for the Cardinal, that is their third team foul. Carolina also with three here in the second half. And Ed Cota, the senior from Brooklyn, at the line. Tenacious fight here in the South Region in Birmingham, and underdog North Carolina with Ed Cota at the line has taken a three-point lead, 39-36. Stanford led by as many as eight late in the first half, a 14-0 run, eight straight points at the end of the first half, six in a row to start the second half, bolted Carolina in front, but Stanford rallying from seven down themselves to tie at 36, and now Cota has given North Carolina, with that free throw, a 39-36 lead.
And in the first half, Cota was unable to penetrate inside. They started to let Forte handle the basketball a little bit more, and that's loosened up Cota somewhat. He's been able to come off some of the curls and some of the picks of Chris Lang and Brendan Haywood.
6 points now for Cota. Tony Giovacchini, left-hander now at point guard, along with Ryan Mendez. This Mendez with the ball usually comes in, scores quickly. Mosley trying to get inside against Forte. Aaron Collins, one of the big twins for Stanford, and Haywood up high to swat it away. Mendez for three, and he hits again. My, oh my, can he shoot from outside?
And he has been a mini microwave here this afternoon. 10 points off the bench, and as soon as he comes in, he's effective. Big game player. When Stanford needs some offense, they go to Mendez.
Julius Peppers outside, the 6'7 defensive end star freshman football player at Carolina. Haywood back to Lang. Lang is bumped into by Collins. No whistle. And back comes Giovacchini for Stanford, and the Cardinal with a chance to get back on top.
I'll tell you, the beef is sizzling in the paint.
Peppers, quick hands. That's like a sack for Peppers, and he holds his man down as Cota comes the other way, and he is fouled. Fans wanted a flagrant foul. It is not. It's the first on David Mosley.
Well, Peppers, if you take a look on your right side of your screen, you're going to see Peppers doing a little bit of football there. Look at the dive, little body block, roll over, and Cota comes over and get it.
Now you're not going anywhere, he says to Giovacchini. Ed Cota at the line. He's now 3 for 3. That's his seventh point. Has 8 assists. As you saw earlier on the graphic, only the third man with 1,000 assists in his career. Bobby Hurley, Chris Corciani, two other former ACC stars, the only other two over the 1,000 mark in national play.
And Cota has really had to learn to play without the likes of Antoine Jameson and Vince Carter, where it was a much easier assist.
Just think if they were still in school at Carolina.
Oh, my gosh.
41-39, North Carolina leading number one seed Stanford. Mendez, he's drawing respect, so they come off Mendez, and that sets up Collins with an easy two. Jaron Collins has four.
Well, anytime Mendez has the ball, all eyes are focused on him, and that gives Collins the ability to slip by Haywood.
Forte driving up the lane. Mosley able to save to Mattson. Giovacchini brings it in. Tie game at 41. Under 12 to play. Collins with Haywood. Knocked away. And saved by Peppers. Boy, is he strong in there. What hands.
Well, when he gets his hands on the ball, he might as well get back on defense, because you're not getting it away from him.
Forte into Lang. There's that patented jump hook, and Chris Lang gives Carolina the two-point lead with his 10th point of the game.
And whatever pain that was in his chest, I hope it, you know, it's something that he can build on, and because he's really been effective here in the second half.
Giovacchini to Mendez. You got Peppers now on Mendez trying to slow him down.
Collins inside with Haywood. Joe Bikini, a rare shot, partially blocked by Cota, but Mendez there for another offensive second chance. Cardinal, if they should win this game, that's going to be key, their ability to get offensive rebounds.
And the Tar Heels have done a good job of taking Collins and matching out, but it's been mostly and Mendez the ones that's getting the offensive boards.
Timeout, North Carolina. The Tar Heels. With a 43-41 lead, Chris Lang stars.
Will Chamberlain in Kansas, and those at three overtimes in the final.
43-41, North Carolina trying to make it to the Sweet 16. If they do, it'll be the 17th time in the last 20 years. Weren't expected. Some thought they wouldn't even get into the tournament with a disappointing year. Playing tough against number one seed Stanford.
People say the only reason that Tar Heels were able to get in the tournament was their tough schedule in November.
Haywood triples. Lang unable to tip it in. Batted out of bounds by Jacobson. Ball to North Carolina with it a timeout. 10:21 left in the second half. Tar Heels by two.
The eighth seed with a two-point lead over top-seeded Stanford. The battle inside between Brendan Haywood of Carolina, Mark Madsen of Stanford. They each averaged right around 13 points a game during the regular season. Haywood off his 28-point performance two nights ago. 9 points. Madsen only three thus far in the game.
And one thing surprisingly, well, not so surprisingly, but Haywood has really been effective on the defensive end. He's had some key block shots in the paint that has denied Stanford.
Capel with nice a little 10-footer. Good out-of-bounds play. And Jason Collins able to collect the rebound for Stanford. Joe Bikini, the point guard, into Collins. Collins with a move around Haywood and gets the goal. 43 all here in Birmingham as we hit the 10-minute mark second half.
And both teams trying to get the ball down inside. There hadn't been a lot of free throws here, but they're trying to get it deep.
And Haywood with a lob pass, and Jacobson reaching in, trying to rake it away, and it was last touched by him.
Really a tough pass from the top of the key to get that ball over the top. I believe it has to be a little crisp pass inside, but Collins is a huge player to try to throw it over the top.
Forte. Freshman patience, not trying to force any shots from outside. Capel takes it inside, and it's batted away to North Carolina with 12 on the shot clock.
Good interior passing by Capel's Forte, drilling to the paint, trying to find either Lang or Haywood for the high percentage shot.
Tied at 43. Forte, tough shot, goes right over the rim, and Collins with the rebound. But that shot of Guthridge just exhaling deeply tells it all. All on the line, 9.5 to go, tied at 43. Winner goes to Austin, Texas for Friday night Sweet 16 battle against the winner of the game to follow, Tennessee and Connecticut.
A lot of switching taking place. Carolina knowing they must take away Mendez and Jacobson, the shooter, switching same side.
Collins over Lang, and Lang with a block, but got him with a body. Ball was clean, but picks up his third foul with the body.
Yeah, anytime you get a good clean block, you might want to watch the left hand and see where it is. There's a little body contact there. Tough call.
To the line.
Jaron Collins.
He's 8 minutes younger than his twin, Jason. Give Stanford a one-point lead at 44-43. And here's Julius Peppers in for Chris Lang, Carolina's bulky 270-pound football star. And he has made his presence known here in Birmingham.
No question about it. He's been applying the beef, but he's been playing match. And now he's going to have to play Jason Collins, who's a few years taller.
Papa Collins cheering on his sons. 45-43, less than 9 to go.
Forte and Jacobson have struggled somewhat. Cota treating his own shot.
And the rebound ripped down by Jaron Capel.
looking to get the ball inside and get that foul on Haywood. They've been going to him every time inside. Good jump hook.
Jason. The twin Jason Collins able to hit the jump hook. It's fourth point of the game. 2-point lead for Stanford.
This is why Stanford is so tough. You may be able to stick close to them, but eventually they're going to wear you down, pounding it inside and shooting from the outside. Nice jump hook move by Haywood. The answer, Collins.
47-45, Haywood in double figures with 10. Under 8 minutes to play, second half. Jacobson wanted to go up with a three and barely able to do the toe dance to avoid the travel. Into Collins. Rebound Haywood. And with the score 47-45, Pota, the clever senior point guard, brings it in for North Carolina.
This really lulls you to sleep. Pota, very good at taking his time, and then all of a sudden, boom, he's exploding off the dribble.
He'll take that short jumper. Haywood kept it alive. Pota battling off Pepper's hands and Forte. Not there, and a foul on the back goes against North Carolina.
Boy, I tell you, the matchup in the center is extremely good. There's Collins with his jump hook over Haywood. Point, counterpoint, here comes Haywood. Right back, not in my house, right back at Collins with the jump hook. Money time for Haywood.
For City of Angels.
Check the Nortel Network game summary that the field goal percentage of North Carolina, 41%, against the team that is trying to break the all-time record for lowest field goal percentage allowed. 35% is what the opponents have shot against Stanford this year. And there's the Stanford band and
an
intruder.
He changed jobs on it.
Yes, sir. Go get it, Spencer. I wonder if he knows celebrate. That's a great
one. It reminds me of Bo Jackson, the dual occupation, a reporter and a drummer.
47-45, Stanford with the ball and the lead. Team foul situation. Carolina has four. As Jacobson misses another long-range shot and Lang rebounds. Stanford has 14 fouls, Carolina 5. Shaheen Holloway of Seton Hall, you saw the injury, turned his ankle earlier today. They took him to the hospital. X-rays were negative. He won't return today, but perhaps if Seton Hall advances, he will be available next week. Here it's been close throughout. Stanford led by 8 late in the first half, and then an 8-0 run by North Carolina gave them a 1-point lead at the half as Cota can't hit the short jumper, and Matson in the crowd able to pull it in for Stanford.
I tell you, when Matson gets a rebound, he really clears people out of there. You don't want to be in the radius of those elbows.
Inside to Jaron Collins. McDonald back in the game at point guard. Mosley hawked by Forte. He's been the big gun for Stanford today with 17. Gets away from Forte. The fall away is short. And the rebound to North Carolina. Jason Capel, and here is Cota deliberately with that high dribble, bringing it in. Looking for a tie or a go-ahead three.
And with Haywood out of the game, you got to look for Forte to get it inside to Lang, who has that jump hook working for him right now. Looks like they're going to try to work it around to Cota to be the setup man. False screen for Lang. Looked like a little out of sync, though.
Forte with a drive, and it's tied at 47 on the freshman's 8th point of the game.
Well, they went from being out of sync to Forte sinking two off the glass.
With 5 minutes to go, it's dead even at 47. Mosley for three. And Lang brings it in for North Carolina.
Carolina did a good job with Brendan Haywood out of the game of securing the boards, not allowing Stanford to get too many offensive boards in the second half.
Jacobson and Capel.
I really think Forte really is going to create off the dribble. He's a guy that can do it. But Mosley stingy with the defense.
Six on the clock. Cota behind the back. Three on the clock. Forte. Yes, a big shot at the buzzer. It counts, and Carolina leads 50-47. Joseph Forte, the Rookie of the Year in the Atlantic Coast Conference, with a crucial hit.
And a foul inside. Coda and Lang reaching. And it'll go against Lang.
Tar Heels running the clock down to the last second, and the nice follow-through, finger pointing to the goal. Forte knocking down.
Carolina kids enjoying that shot as Lang now with four fouls. Peppers goes out. Lang stays in with four, and Haywood returns for North Carolina. So they've got two big men. Lang 6'10", Haywood 7 feet. Mosley again. That's three straight times down court, James Worthy, that Stanford has gone for the long shot, not trying to work it inside.
And they know that Haywood has three fouls, and Collins has been very successful. Madsen in there hasn't heard from him lately. He really should be trying to get that fourth foul on Haywood.
Forte, another three. Yes! A 360 around the iron and down the hole. It's 53-47.
And Forte's a type of player, once he hits a couple, he can give you three or four in a row when he gets going. They said a good down pick for him on that particular play. There's Madsen inside, blocked by Haywood.
And here comes Carolina with a 10-0 run. They had a 14-0 run carrying over from first to second half. Eight straight at the end of the first half and six in a row to open this second half. And now another string of 10.
Held Stanford to 34% shooting in the first half. That sticky defense.
Under 3 minutes to go, and North Carolina with the ball, eating the clock. 6-point advantage.
Gotta look for Forte. He's been good at coming off those picks, although right now they run a little 1-4 for Coda to create inside the lane.
5 seconds to go, and Lang had it partially blocked by Jacobson. Crucial trip down court for the Stanford Cardinal. McDonald takes it inside. Oh, what a nice move. A big spin off the glass to keep it away from Haywood. 53-49. First points for Michael McDonald.
Really put Haywood to sleep. Had Collins over there. Thought he was going to dish it off, but kissed it off the glass.
Down to 2:10 left in this second half. Carolina by four. And a foul away from the ball. As both Haywood and, who is it, Madsen go down.
Good bench reaction. Good shot by Forte. Look at the Carolina bench. And Mike Montgomery saying, come on, let's go. Let's not give up.
And Madsen has just picked up his second foul. The game, no one has been tougher on the opponent shooting than Stanford, but in this game, it's North Carolina out hitting the Cardinal at 42.9%. Stanford looking for an all-time record, 35% field goal percentage against, best in the nation, best ever. But Mike Montgomery has seen this team of Bill Guthridge, North Carolina, much maligned during the course of the year, play a terrific game. And it's a 4-point Tar Heel lead with 2 minutes to go. They've had two big runs in the game, North Carolina, 14-0. That spanned the first and second half, and another 8-point run here in the middle of the second half to take the lead. Haywood has been the spark for them, the big 7-foot center with the ball. He better get rid of it, close to the 5-second count. Haywood has it go through his hands and picked off by Michael McDonald, the point guard for Stanford.
Well, you can't take the ball down in the middle of the floor. That's a no-no. That's trapped all the way, and that's exactly what forced a turnover for Forte.
Collins had it right in his hands and fumbled it back to North Carolina.
That's what it'll be all about. It'll be about turning the ball over, protecting it, and who can get to the line and knock down the free throws here in the last minute, 15 seconds.
Jacobson and Capel down to 15 seconds on the clock, and if Carolina works it just the way they want to, there'll be less than a minute remaining before they shoot. They don't have to, as the foul committed by Jacobson, his first, and that will send the freshman Forte to the line. He's had a couple of big threes on the rally here late for North Carolina, and Bill Guthridge wants a timeout on the Tar Heel bench. 1:05 left in the second half. Carolina by four. Here with North Carolina leading And 65 seconds left. Team fouls both at six. So fouls from now on will send players to the line. Four timeouts left for Stanford. Now Stanford led at 47-43 with more than 8 minutes to go. But since that time, they scored but 2 points with 10 Carolina points to give the Tar Heels the lead, 53-49.
And you're going to see the defensive pressure pick up quite a bit.
Coda
for Stanford
respecting the chance at a block and the foul, and that will send Ed Coda to the line. Clock stopped with 1:02 left in the game. Foul is on Michael McDonald, his third.
Free throws become very important along with the possession error, which now stands in Carolina's favor. But keeping the ball in Ed Coda's hands, letting him create, and having your good foul shooters handle the ball, critical down the stretch.
3 for 4 today is Ed Coda. Oh, that's a big miss on the front end of a 1-1. Stanford the other way, down by 4. Less than a minute to play.
Looking for Jacobson and Mosley.
Jacobson for 3. It's not there, and Haywood is. And foul. I believe Jacobson after the miss came in, although Mattson is raising his hand. If it's Mattson, it's his third.
Well, Stanford got the look they want. If Carolina's going to stop that, they're going to have to switch on McDonald, Mosley, and Jacobson, regardless of the size, to take away the open three-point shot.
Haywood, as he steps to the line, the big seven-footer, his free throw percentage just under 63%, missed his only attempt today.
Well, you got to knock these down in this time. 49 seconds, crunch time.
54-49. The number one seed, Stanford. The two number ones from the West, Arizona, defeated yesterday in the second round. And now Stanford facing possible elimination. North Carolina by 6. It'll take a pair of threes now for Stanford.
Got to switch on Mosley and Jacobson. Can't give them the open ones.
Mosley can't hit it. Kept alive by Mendez. He's a good three-point shooter. And Peppers, the bulky defensive end, throws down Mendez.
Mendez has been the most active player for Stanford today. As a guard, he's been on the offensive boards, hit some big shots, got a big key rebound, and he's going to the sideline because he may have drawn a little blood. I'm not sure. He's checking the nose. Hard contact, maybe.
Appears to be the case. Mendez, with a shooter's eye, that's for certain, came off the bench and hit his first two shots in the first half. Has not been to the free throw line today. He was 4 for 4 in the Friday night win against South Carolina State. Let's go back to the contact on the foul.
Well, if anybody's going to hit, you don't want Julius Peppers, 270 pounds, coming down on you. And that was didn't look like much, but look at the chest and the shoulders on Peppers, and that's painful even from where I'm sitting.
Yeah, the quarterbacks around the Atlantic Coast Conference will attest that was just a little baby pat from Peppers the way he attacks. He has played a key role in the two wins, if they are two, for North Carolina. As he's come off the bench, this is a team that is short on depth. Peppers joining after the football season. Bill Guthridge basically has gone with 7 men in both games of this South region. And Peppers, perhaps the unknown, that has given more than Guthridge and the Carolina fans might have expected.
Well, when Chris Lang went down, Peppers wanted to play basketball. He walked on to the UNC basketball team and unexpectedly has been the gem for Coach Guthridge. He's a good defensive player, great body, and the ability to defend on the post, meaning he can push bigger players away from the basket, making them put it on the floor. So very instrumental has been Peppers.
Mendez coolly drops in the first free throw. It's 55-50. And timeout is called with 37.4 seconds left. Number one seed Stanford deep in trouble, down by 5. Veteran coach Bill Guthridge in the Carolina huddle, so long an assistant, a valued assistant of the legendary Dean Smith. Last year, his team lost in the first round to Weber State. This year, they were favored to win the ACC, finished 9-7. The critics have been crying for Bill Guthridge's scalp. The fans have been upset by the lack of success this year, so this would be a tremendous redeeming moment for him if he could upset the number one seed and advance to the Sweet 16. Here in Birmingham, it's Ryan Mendez of Stanford, down 55-50. He hits the second free throw, 55-51. North Carolina trying to pull the upset, beat the number one seed. Here in the South, there's 37.4 seconds remaining, and North Carolina leads by four.
Mike Montgomery took that timeout to set up this press and also to realize who to foul on the court. They don't want much time to lead the clock, 35 seconds.
And they may have fouled the wrong man, at least statistically. Capel is the best free throw shooter on the season for North Carolina, hitting over 83%. He's not been to the line today, however. This 6'8 sophomore from Chesapeake, Maryland, with a 4-point lead, a 1-1. Both teams in the 1-1. Stanford's next foul will give Carolina two shots.
35 seconds, a lot of time for Stanford. They can put it up quick. Mosley Jacobson outside, two threes. Very explosive.
Shooters roll. It's 56-51. As Mark Manson returns and Jaron Collins out for Stanford. Only 3 points for the co-captain of the Stanford Cardinal and their leader. Son of a coach, his dad coaches at Old Dominion, makes it a two-possession, 2-3-point game for Stanford. Stanford with one field goal in the last 7.5 minutes. They go inside to Manson and get the conceded two and quickly call timeout. 26.7 seconds remain. North Carolina by four. The University of North Carolina Tar Heels, their success synonymous with the NCAA tournament. In fact, this is the 26th consecutive year they've made it to this championship. That's an all-time record. Many felt they had limited chance to advance, and here they are, 26.7 seconds away from knocking out the number one seed Stanford Cardinal. They lead 57-53. Stanford has never beaten North Carolina in 8 previous games. Peppers gets it in, and the immediate foul on the freshman Joseph Forte as Mendez stops the clock. Just a half second use, his second foul.
Well, Carolina really spreading the floor almost in a box in order to break the pressure, thinking that Forte and Cota can outquick their men to get open. Take a look at the Stanford bench right now. A little bit concerned with only 26 seconds left, knowing that they have to foul and depend on Carolina missing free throws from here on out.
This talented freshman Forte, he's a 74% free throw shooter. Misses that one is Chris Lang, and the Carolina bench with their deepest hopes riding with Forte. He gets one out of two, 5-point lead.
A little light pressure added by Carolina. Not to give up the easier, but here comes Mosley.
McConnell to Mosley. He goes for the three, and it's partially blocked, and Haywood gets it in the foul immediately by Stanford that stops the clock at 16.3, and North Carolina goes to the other end with a 5-point lead. Mark Manson with his fourth foul. And things have grown to a desperate stage for the men from Stanford as North Carolina, eighth seed. And a couple of years ago, they went into the tournament in the same manner. Actually, 10 years ago when they were the eighth seed. That's the worst seed they've had in 10 years, repeating this year. They did defeat Oklahoma in the second round, and Oklahoma was number one. First one is missed by Haywood.
Carolina's done a better job. I think one of the key factors is that they did not allow Stanford to get the offensive boards that they got in the first half. Haywood misses the second.
5-point game. Hurrying into the offensive end is McDonald. Jacobson from about 35 feet away. And the rebound, Carolina, solo Forte. And that should do it. Forte slam will send North Carolina into the Sweet 16. North Carolina 60-53. A stunning defeat for the Stanford Cardinal, the number one seed from the West, sent here to the South, the number one seed in the West, Arizona. So the two Pac-10 powerhouses have been KO'd in the second round of this NCAA tournament. The perennial power from the ACC, North Carolina, flexes its muscles again. What an upset. The Chevrolet players of the game, Brendan Haywood, 12 points and 8 rebounds, but he played tough the entire game at both ends. David Mosley, most of his points early, 17 points and 8 rebounds, but Carolina's defense shutting out Stanford down the stretch as the Cardinals turn cold in the final 8 minutes of the game. And so North Carolina has advanced. They've assured their position in the Sweet 16 and will meet the winner of the University of Connecticut Tennessee game that will follow here from Birmingham. Oh my! And that's it from Birmingham in the first game. The victory for the North Carolina Tar Heels will return later for game two. Veteran coach Bill Guthridge in the Carolina huddle, so long an assistant, a valued assistant of the legendary Dean Smith. Last year, his team lost in the first round to Weber State. This year, they were favored to win the ACC, finished 9-7. The critics have been crying for Bill Guthridge's scalp. The fans have been upset by the lack of success this year. So this would be a tremendous redeeming moment for him if he could upset the number one seed and advance to the Sweet 16. Here in Birmingham, it's Ryan Mendez of Stanford, down 55-50. He hits the second free throw, 55-51. North Carolina trying to pull the upset, beat the number one seed. Here in the South, there's 37.4 seconds remaining, and North Carolina leads by four.
Mike Montgomery took that timeout to set up this press and also to realize who to foul on the court. They don't want much time to lead the clock, 35 seconds.
And they may have fouled the wrong man, at least statistically. Capel is the best free throw shooter on the season for North Carolina, hitting over 83%. He's not been to the line today, however. This 6'8 sophomore from Chesapeake, Maryland, with a 4-point lead, a 1-1. Both teams in the 1-1. Stanford's next foul will give Carolina two shots.
35 seconds, a lot of time for Stanford. They can put it up quick. Mosley, Jacobson outside, two threes. Very explosive.
Shooters roll. It's 56-51. As Mark Manson returns and Jaron Collins out for Stanford. Only 3 points for the co-captain of the Stanford Cardinal and their leader. Son of a coach, his dad coaches at Old Dominion, makes it a two-possession, 2 3-point game for Stanford. Stanford with one field goal in the last 7.5 minutes. They go inside to Manson and get the conceded two and quickly call timeout. 26.7 seconds remain. North Carolina by four. The University of North Carolina Tar Heels, their success synonymous with the NCAA tournament. In fact, this is the 26th consecutive year they've made it to this championship. That's an all-time record. Many felt they had limited chance to advance, and here they are, 26.7 seconds away from knocking out the number one seed Stanford Cardinal. They lead 57-53. Stanford has never beaten North Carolina in 8 previous games. Peppers gets it in, and the immediate foul on the freshman Joseph Forte as Mendez stops the clock. Just a half second use, his second foul.
Well, Carolina really spreading the floor almost in a box in order to break the pressure, thinking that Forte and Cota can outquick their men to get open. Take a look at the Stanford bench right now. A little bit concerned with only 26 seconds left, knowing that they have to foul and depend on Carolina missing free throws from here on out.
This talented freshman Forte.
He's a 74% free throw shooter. Misses that one is Chris Lang and the Carolina bench with their deepest hopes riding with Forte. He gets one out of two. 5-point lead.
A little light pressure added by Carolina. Not to give up the easier, but here comes Mosley.
McConnell to Mosley. He goes for the three, and it's partially blocked, and Haywood gets it in the foul immediately by Stanford that stops the clock at 16.3, and North Carolina goes to the other end with a 5-point lead. Mark Madsen with his fourth foul. And things have grown to a desperate stage for the men from Stanford as North Carolina, eighth seed. And a couple of years ago, they went into the tournament in the same manner. Actually, 10 years ago when they were the eighth seed. That's the worst seed they've had in 10 years, repeating this year. They did defeat Oklahoma in the second round, and Oklahoma was number one. First one is missed by Haywood.
Carolina's done a better job. I think one of the key factors is that they did not allow Stanford to get the offensive boards that they got in the first half. Hayward misses the second.
5-point game. Hurrying into the offensive end is McDonald. Jacobson from about 35 feet away. And the rebound, Carolina, solo Forte. And that should do it. Forte's slam will send North Carolina into the Sweet 16. It's over. A big upset in Birmingham. The North Carolina Tar Heels win it 60-53. A stunning defeat for the Stanford Cardinal, the number one seed from the West, sent here to the South, the number one seed in the West, Arizona. So the two Pac-10 powerhouses have been KO'd in the second round of this NCAA tournament. The perennial power from the ACC, North Carolina, flexes its muscles again. What an upset. The Chevrolet players of the game, Brendan Haywood, 12 points and 8 rebounds, but he played tough the entire game at both ends. David Mosley, most of his points early, 17 points and 8 rebounds. But Carolina's defense shutting out Stanford down the stretch as the Cardinals turn cold in the final 8 minutes of the game. And so North Carolina has advanced. They've assured their position in the Sweet 16 and will meet the winner of the University of Connecticut-Tennessee game that will follow here from Birmingham. Oh, my! And that's it from Birmingham in the first game. The victory for the North Carolina Tar Heels will return later for Game 2.